Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. 3 weeks ago, I made a video titled My Worst Financial Mistakes. Today, I'm gonna be walking you guys through my five best financial decisions. Well, you guys know if you've been following the channel for a while, I'm a big supercar fanatic. And on this channel, I share those supercars, but I also talk about how I was able to acquire those supercars. So I talk a lot about my financial situation as it stands today. Well, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and share with you those five best financial decisions that I've made. So let's get started. Number one, going to college. That's right. Going to college was the number one best financial decision I could have made in my life. And I'll tell you why. Growing up in the area I grew up in, there were not many people who went to college. And in my own family, I was the very first person to go to college. Now, I know college is not for everybody. I get that. But let me tell you why college was so important to me. Well, like I said, when you grew up in a financial situation like I grew up in, we didn't have very much. My mom worked extremely hard to take care of us to make sure we had our basic necessities, roof over our head, clothes on our back, food to eat. So, you know, as an 18-year-old kid trying to figure out what was next in my life, college, in my opinion, was that next ultimate step in order to help me figure out what I really wanted to do with the rest of my life from a financial standpoint. So college certainly provided me that platform. It allowed me to further my education and explore things from an intellectual standpoint that I never had thought of. And in return, it opened up my eyes to a whole world of possibilities. So that's where, when I talk a lot about dreaming and visualizing, that's where it all started for me, guys, in college. It also taught me time management. It taught me how to make a decision and stick to that decision and work through it. It also taught me a lot about fiscal responsibility. Even though early on in my working days, I didn't necessarily pay attention to it, I was taught about some of those financial responsibilities you'll need to possess as an adult in this world. And I learned all of that, guys, through college. So college for me was certainly what I needed. It pointed me in the right direction. It also educated me. I was a little bit more intellectual and understood how economics work to a certain extent in this world. So it gave me that platform I needed in order to get a head start. It also provided me a lot of options. Coming out of college, you guys know my story. I played several years in the NFL, and by no means through that experience in the NFL was I able to set myself up for the rest of my life. It was not like that. And you also guys know my story. All the money I made playing my first 2 or 3 years in the NFL, I only played 3 years, I spent. So I had to go back to my roots, the things that I learned in college, how to manage my financial situation, which I did. And I was able to get myself back on track. But the number one best financial decision I could have made was going to college. So let's go on to number two. The second best financial decision I made was practicing delayed gratification. Now, you guys know I talk a lot about delayed gratification in my videos. And I want today to just kind of expound on that a little bit and what delayed gratification means to me. Now, in my 30s, I started making pretty good money in the financial industries sector, which I was working in. And I had to come to a decision that, hey, I can go ahead and live for the moment and spend every penny that I make and not plan for the future. You know that old saying, you live for today, but you plan for tomorrow. In my 30s, that really started lingering in my spirit to, hey man, at this point, you'll be 40 in a minute. So if you don't start saving and investing those savings and paying yourself first, which I talk a lot about as well in my videos, you're gonna be in sad shape in your 40s and your 50s and your 60s. So delayed gratification was just a state of mind to me, guys. You know, I was buying things in my 20s, back to my NFL days, I was buying things in my 20s that I really didn't even need. I was just spending money to spend money, just poor fiscal responsibility. But in my 30s, all that changed. And all of that changed because of delayed gratification. And part of that delayed gratification is paying yourself first. So what I did was I started just cutting out all the things that I really didn't need. If it wasn't a necessity in my life, guys, I cut it out from an expense standpoint. And that delayed gratification just snowballed for me. When I got to my late 30s, early 40s, I could have easily started buying cars and things of that nature, but I decided not to because it wasn't the right time. Now, again, delayed gratification does not mean you can't live a good lifestyle. But for me, the way I utilized it was, instead of having three cars in my 30s, I just bought one nice car and that's what I used. And everything else, all the rest of that money, I just tucked away. Instead of having three or four or five expensive watches, like the one I have on today, I only had one, just one watch to wear. That's delayed gratification. It's not, at least to me and my definition of it, it's not denying yourself all the creature comforts of your lifestyle. What it's doing is it forces you not to exceed that. Live modestly. And that's what I did through my 30s and through my 40s. So it has put me in a position through delayed gratification. Remember I talked about live for today, but prepare for tomorrow. It put me in a position to be able to have a great tomorrow. So the number two thing that financial decision that I made that has worked out very well for me is delayed gratification. Now let's go on to number three. The third best financial decision I've ever made was getting into real estate. That's right, guys. When I was 26 years old, I bought my first home, and that started my long love affair with real estate investing. And I've been doing it ever since. So real estate has, God, you know, I made a video maybe a week or two ago about how I 10X'd my net worth. Guys, 90% of that was through real estate. Just being diligent, buying the right properties at the right time, putting tenants in them, allowing that property to appreciate in value over the 3, 4, 5 years that I owned it, and then exiting that property and taking that profit from that exit and reinvesting it back into more real estate. And I just did that, guys, religiously for about 10 years. Just did not stop. Just kept on doing it. Now, the thing for me, though, was I never was a guy that owned more than five properties, though. But those five properties were all in single-family real estate, single-family homes. And they were in growth areas. Areas that I knew through research and talking with professional real estate agents and people like that, I knew those markets were going to continue to grow. So that's what I invested in. And I put a good tenant in those properties and I just was patient and continued to earn those rents until I was able to exit the properties. So real estate really is the game changer for me. And it's the third best financial decision that I've made in my life. So let's go on to number four. Number four is additional streams of income. You guys know I talk a lot about additional streams of income. One of those additional streams of income I created was luxury watch sales. Well, basically, I go out in the market and I buy luxury watches like this Rolex Submariner 2 date that I have on for deep discounts, and then I turn around and take that watch and I remarket it online and for profit. That's luxury watch sales. And I've done that, guys, for the last probably 10 years, and it's been good to me. The other one I created, additional stream of income that I really talk about a lot, is stock market investing. Now, disclaimer, I'm not a licensed stock investor advisor or mutual fund advisor or EFT advisor. I'm not. I'm just a normal guy who decided, hey, this looks pretty interesting. I've spent 25 years in the financial industry. Why not capitalize on that experience and figure out a way to make some money? And that's what I did through stock market investing. So I don't invest in a lot of different companies. I invest in financial services companies that have done pretty well for me. My recommendation for any of you guys that are thinking about investing in stocks, bonds, mutual funds, EFTs, you name it, please do yourself a favor. Go out and find you a really, really good licensed investment advisor to walk you through that process. It'll save you a lot of time, but most importantly, guys, it'll save you a lot of money. So that's my recommendation. But those additional three streams of income really help put me in a position to be able to buy these supercars that I have, the 458, the GT3, the Porsche 911 GT3, the Mercedes SL63 AMG, and all the other cars that I've owned. These three additional streams of income put me in a position to be able to take advantage and pay for these cars through these three additional streams of income. I'm also in the process of creating more additional streams of income. So more to come on that. But that's the fourth best financial decision that I've made in my life. Now, the fifth one, guys, believe it or not, are you guys, the YouTube channel, the YouTube community. That's the fifth best financial decision that I've made in my life. And not because I'm making money on YouTube, is because of you guys. With you guys being so involved with your comments and your feedback on the Instagram page and through the videos and the comments, man, it's rejuvenated me. It's rejuvenated my spirit for creating additional streams of income, more additional streams of income. And it's also a big, huge blessing to be able to give you guys my 25 years of financial experience to people out there in this world who feel like they may need some guidance. So that's where I come in. And guys, that's been a financial blessing for me. And I really appreciate you guys really diving in and asking questions and supporting the channel the way you've done over the last year. It's been phenomenal. And guys, it has been my fifth best financial decision, is investing my time in you guys. So thank you very much for that. Well, guys, that's it. Those are the five best financial decisions that I've made in my life. I would ask you guys to think about your financial decisions. How many are your best? Do you have any that are not so good? Think about that. And if you want to change that, you can. You guys know how to reach me. You can certainly drop a comment in the video here on YouTube, or you can hit me on Instagram through DM at RichardFain28. Well, all right, guys. Thank you very much for taking some of your time out to stop by the channel today and check out this video. I really appreciate it. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, please consider subscribing, share the video, and give me a thumbs up. It helps out the channel and it helps me as well. But as always, guys, keep chasing greatness. And I will catch you guys on the next video. Peace.